I bet everyone that has Windows Movie Maker is wondering, can I do the cloning thing? Because you probably heard on YouTube about that you could do a cloning thing. Here's the three things you need. There's this website that has translations or whatever the heck it's called, little effects that you need. And then all you need is a camera, a steady camera. Just put it on a book or a tripod, and then you can start doing it. And what you need to do is you need to have an area, like put tape down where one of the two people are going to be standing, because if you're clones hit each other, it'll look like half of them's not there. So what you gotta do is you have to make sure they're all in the right position for each shot you're taking. Instead of just, let's say, pausing it every 5 seconds, just keep it recording and just cut out the part you don't want. That way you just move your guy over there and you just cut that out of him moving over there instead of pause, because the camera shakes when you do that. And then let's say, you know, you have Windows Movie Maker and you're not very satisfied with it. There's a lot of things it could do. Like I said, the cloning thing. There's like different effects you could get for it. I mean, you could even edit the effects on there. And there's actually a way, I don't remember exactly how to do this, but there is a website, I forgot what it's about, but you can make it so you can use a green screen on Windows Movie Maker. And just, there's all kinds of things you could do. Just all you have to do is check out on the internet. But I'll give you the link right now on the stuff you need. And I'll give you a tutorial that I used. But I mean, I could show you how to do it, but I'm not on the computer that I need to use to show you. So I'll just give you the link to a tutorial, and then I'll give you a link to the add-on you need. And Vista users, you can use this. At first, because I have a Vista, I thought I wasn't going to be able to do it because I kept adding the new effects and it didn't work. But you just have to download the older version called 2.4 or 2.something for Vista. And then with the XP users, they don't have to change anything. But yeah, that's pretty much all you need to know how to do it, and then just follow a tutorial on how to really make the clones. And then I'll have a few links to the technique being used, and then, yeah. So that's all you need to know for this, so bye.